the muscles of the body. The muscles of the body. We actually have over 600 muscles. How many muscles? 640 skeletal muscles. Now I'm going to ask you two questions, and then I'm going to answer it pretty quickly, but give you something to think about for a moment. There's three kinds of muscles. What are those kinds? There are four purposes for skeletal muscles. What are the four purposes? What are the four functions of skeletal muscles? Now, we have, like I said, over 640 skeletal muscles, right? We got some trapeziuses, we got some rhomboids, we got some teres majors and deltoids and pectoralis majors and biceps brachii and soleus. We got some gluteus medius and gluteus minimus and gluteus maximus. Damn, look at her. Is that a gluteus minimus? Nah, that's a gluteus maximus. And latissimus dorsi, triceps brachii. So these are the main ones, right? Rectus femoris. Rectus femoris, orbicularis oris, extensor digitorum, gracilis, vastus lateris, thoracolumbar fascia, extensor carpi radialis, extensor carpi ulnaris, palmaris longus, flexor carpi radialis, semimembranous, semitendinosus, biceps femoris, gastrocnemius, soleus lateral, let's see, bones, joints, ligaments. Okay, so there you go. There you go. You know, you haven't really woke up in the morning until you've talked about the extensor carpi radialis, right? The thoracolumbar fascia is like a big-ass fucking muscle, too. Oh, how's your thoracolumbar fascia? The fuck you call me? I called you an orbicularis oris and a rectus femoris. Oh, yeah, well, we about to fight. I was calling you a muscle, you stupid fuck, but you a dumb motherfucker now. Sit there and say you strong. Sit there and say you a trapezius, man. You my deltoid. You my latissimus dorsi. You my latissimus dorsi, bro. And you want to get insult. You my bursae. You're my bursae. B-U-R-S-A-E. It's a muscle, bursae. Okay, so we got bones, we got joints, we got ligaments, we got tendons, we got nerves, we got blood vessels, and we got muscles. Now, we have 98.6, we generate heat. Apparently, muscles make up 40% of our body's masses. So, muscles make up 40% of our body's mass. When people say, well, where does, you know, the temperature, we have 98.6. Where does all that heat? Our body generates heat. And actually, our muscles are the ones that generate most of the heat, and they produce the heat as a byproduct. They produce the heat as a byproduct. But also, now I just read a study that said something, well, there might be something about, they produce heat as a byproduct, but there's also like a little, there's a hormone or some kind of chemical that's like a little light that just keeps, you know, homeostasis, keeps your temperature right at a very nice even keel. So there's some kind of thing, some kind of element or molecule that keeps the light on, so to speak, when it comes to the temperature of your body. If you've ever been cold, the temperature of your body, you only got so many, at what, 70% of your body's heat goes out of your head, right? I mean, heat rises or whatever, so you want to stay warm, well, make sure you put a hat on. 70% of the heat is going out your head. Put a hat on, well, you're saving a whole bunch of that heat. So those are some of the muscles. So let's answer some of the questions. What are the three types of muscles? You got the cardiac, you got the skeletal, and then you got the smooth muscles. And then they're going to, you know, define them. I think they're actually easier to define, not by the definition, but by what kind of muscles they are. Skeletal muscles are all the muscles that, you know, all the muscles that I just mentioned. They're the biceps, they're the triceps, they're the, you know, your quads and your calves. And we call them quads because there's four muscles there. And I don't know why they call them calves, but they're like three or four different muscles in your calves. So it's not just one big, you know, muscle there. Even if it just kind of looks like it's like three or four muscles. So we got cardiac muscles, we got skeletal muscles, and we got smooth muscles. Cardiac is your heart, your skeletal is your biceps and your triceps and your quads and your calves and your face, you know, muscles, right? The muscle tissue, and then smooth muscles. So you got your heart, and it's a specific muscle, and then you got smooth muscles. And smooth muscles, I'll give you, smooth muscles are like your kidneys, they're like your lungs, they're your urinary tract, your reproductive tract, they're your urethra, they're your kidneys, they're your bladder, they're your stomach, they're your esophagus. All these are smooth muscles. So that which isn't a muscle, right, like skeletal muscles, is probably a smooth muscle. Right? If a stomach on all them glands and all the rest of this shit, and so you got a shit ton of, you know, skeletal muscles, 640 skeletal muscles, and then we got a shit ton of smooth muscles on top of it. But, you know, you can see the distinction, right? Skeletal muscles are like stronger, more durable, and they're completely different how in their makeup. When it comes to the definitions, they give you three words to remember. When it comes to skeletal, remember skeletal, striated, and voluntary. You can move your skeletal muscles, right? You can move your skeletal muscles. They're voluntary. You can think about it. You can move it. Also, your skeletal muscles are striated, right? You got the muscle fibers. And then in those muscle fibers are more muscle fibers called myofibrils or something. So you have, you know, muscle fibers inside of muscle fibers. But the cardiac is involuntary, and it's striated, right? So cardiac, involuntary, striated. So again, it's striated, right? You got those, but it's involuntary. So that's the big difference between cardiac and skeletal muscles. We can control the skeletal. We can't control the cardiac, but they're both striated. They're both got muscle, you know, muscle fibers inside of muscle fibers. Now, the smooth muscles, this is called your visceral. These are called your visceral organs, your digestive tract, your respiratory system. So your breathing and your blood vessels and your arteries and your veins and your stomach and your large and small intestines and, you know, your bladder and your kidneys. These are all smooth muscles. And the reason why visceral is such an important visceral, when someone says it's not a visceral experience, they're saying it doesn't reach their insides. But we can feel our insides. We can, you know, oh, there's something wrong with my stomach. There's something, that's a visceral feeling, right? That's not the five senses. That's not sight. That's not taste. That's not hearing. You can feel inside of you. That's a visceral sense. You have a visceral sense where you can feel the internal organs of yourself. So those are the smooth muscles, the visceral muscles, and those are involuntary. You can't control your kidneys, and they're non-striated. So they're not muscle fibers inside of muscle fibers. That's, again, digestive tract, respiratory system. Those are your smooth muscles. Your cardiac muscles are your heart, right? That's basically just your heart muscle. They're involuntary, just like your smooth muscles are involuntary, but the cardiac muscles share a commonality with the skeletal muscles because they are both striated. So myofilaments, and I want to talk about myofilaments are actin and myosin, actin and myosin. So they have this theory, and I'll just tell you the main theory of how muscles work, right? Muscles contract, and then that's how you're able to pick up things, because they contract. And the way that they contract is they shorten real quick, so they contract. And then even when they're at rest, apparently there's still some ability that can, even when they're at rest, they're, you know, something. Even when they're at rest, most muscles are in a contracted state called muscle tonus. So they're still contracted. Even when you're at a rested state, they're still muscle tonus. It's still somewhat contracted. So they're still kind of holding it together. There's something called ATP, the adrenosine triphosphate thing that turns into ADP plus an inorganic phosphate. You don't need to know that. But what I want you to know, anybody who's paying attention, is the sliding filament theory. So the sliding filament theory is you have these, right? I said you had, you know, muscle fibers on top of muscle fibers. Well, you have these two myofilaments called the actin and the myosin. So learn actin, learn myosin. The actin and the myosin kind of go side by side, and they say this is how muscles work. They move side by side, and then somehow by the breaking and the kin something, I don't know. But there's a bunch of other shit that happened. But essentially, you got the actin, and then you got the myosin. The actin's going this way, right, and the myosin's going this way, and there you go. That's how muscles work, right there. That's how muscles work, okay? If people say, well, how do muscles work? Just start doing this. Like a crazy person, and then that should, you know, explain everything. Now, the muscles, right, they work. You have this actin and this myosin, myofilaments. So these two myofilaments, the actin and the myosin are doing this sliding filament model that produce waste products like lactic acid. So you work out, you have some waste products like lactic acid. But muscles are actually so durable and smart and good and awesome that they can kind of clean up the waste. So muscles can, you know, muscles are fantastic, actually. They're regulating our body's temperature, right? Let's go to the purposes. What are the four purposes of muscles? Well, number one, movement, right? Locomotion. Do the locomotion with me. Gotta swing your hips. So movement, posture, stabilizing joints and generating heat. These are the four functions of muscles. These are more important. This is more important than all the other things that I've talked about so far. Why do you have muscles? What can you do with the muscles that you got? Well, you can move, right? You can move and run and lift shit, right? Of course, we all know that. But, you know, muscles actually go to your posture. Why do you stand up straight? You got gravity. Gravity is the fastest. Gravity is pushing your ass down. They're saying, fuck you. Now, you go into the ground, motherfucker. That's where you belong. Nah, human, you go into the ground where you belong. But the muscles and your back say, no, we're going to stand straight, gravity. What the fuck? You ain't going to do shit. Nah, gravity, we're going to stand tall. So muscles help your posture. They help to stabilize joints. They generate heat. And they help with movement and locomotion. So stabilizing joints. Apparently, muscles actually poorly give reinforcement to the joints. But they help the joints, okay? They help stabilize the joints a little bit. And then generating heat. If you've been cold, I've heard if you're cold, just move around. Well, when you move around, you get warmer, right, at the moment, at the time. And muscles are like that. I read that muscles, you can do a whole bunch of, you know, activity, but they tire very easily. So the main distinguishing characteristic of a muscle is that they could take chemical energy. They could take the nutrients and oxygen and calcium or what have you. They could take oxygen and nutrients, and they can produce movement. Right? So they can take chemical energy and they can convert it to directed mechanical energy. I just ate, you know, a hamburger. Now I am picking up this rock and I'm putting it over here. Now I'm nailing this board and putting it up there. Now I'm taking this tire and I'm putting it on to this car. So that's the main distinguishing thing that a muscle does, transform chemical energy to directed mechanical energy. There's also some distinction between isometric and isotonic contractions. I don't know the difference between isometric and isotonic, but if you want to let me know, tell me down in the comments. Sarcolemma is the plasma membrane of muscle fibers, and then sarcoplasm is the muscle fiber, cytoplasm. So sarco is flesh, myo and M-Y-S is muscles. Whenever you see myosin, myofilaments, that means muscles. And then sarco means flesh, like sarcoplasm and sarcolemma, which, again, respectively, is the muscle fiber, cytoplasm, and the plasma membrane of muscle fibers, sarcoplasma, sarcolemma. So you got the atrophy, which is when your muscles get smaller and they deteriorate. You got hypertrophy, that's when you get bigger muscles. You generate heat, that's a byproduct of metabolism. Heat is a byproduct of metabolism, but it's also, like I said, there's like this little light of mine, there's some hormone or element or some, you know, molecule inside your muscles that just keep burning, just keep that, should have memorized that damn hormone because it seems pretty fucking important, but it maintains your little light, it maintains your 98.6. So, let's see, the main distinguishing characteristics, we got the ATP, the movement, posture, stabilizing joints, generating heat, What the hell do we got these muscles for? Actually, that's intelligence, kinesthesia. So you have proprioception and all these different senses on top of the five senses. But to know your muscles and what they do, that's called kinesthesia. So when you say, you know what, I do know what my muscles do. My muscles help me move. My muscles help me keep an upright posture. Gravity's trying to push me down. Well, fuck you, gravity. My muscles say I'm going to stand tall. Muscles also stabilize joints, and they generate heat. Stabilize joints. People, when you get old, your joints get all fucking out of whack, and then it generates heat, so there you go. Do we need to know anything else? There's hundreds to thousands of muscle fibers in a muscle. Each muscle tissue have nerve endings. They call the balancing out of your body's internal, you know, systems homeostasis. So your body temperature to maintain homeostasis, right? It does. Your muscles do generate heat as a byproduct of metabolism, but muscles also generate heat as its main function too, I think, because of that one study that I read with that hormone that I don't know specifically what I'm... Okay, so let's see here. Let's see. Shorten forcibly. There's four functions of muscles or properties. The excitability, contractibility, extensibility, the elasticity. You don't have to memorize those. Skeletal muscle makes up 40% of the body's mass, so therefore they're responsible. Muscles are most responsible for generating the body's heat. Contracting muscle fibers use huge amount of energy and oxygen and nutrients through an artery. So every muscle has to have an artery going into it. They use a shit ton of oxygen, shit ton of nutrients. And then the muscles give off waste after they do their thing. I think that's it on that page. Myocin is a fibrous protein that forms with actin, the contractile filaments of muscle cells, and it's also involved in motion of other types of cells. Myocin is a superfamily of motor proteins, best known for the role in muscle contraction. Something about eukaryotes. Myosins is a superfamily of molecular motors. Myosins is a superfamily of molecular motors. They interact with actin filaments, and they use the energy of ATP hydrolysis. So ATP, I've seen these letters a lot, ATP, the adenosine triphosphate. The ATP hydrolysis. The ATP hydrolysis to move along these filaments, thereby producing active mechanical forces. So again, the sliding, the actin and the myosin sliding filament theory, the sliding, in fact, it should be the sliding myofilament theory, the sliding muscle filament. So the sliding myofilament theory, again, with the myosin and the goddamn actin, the myosin and the fucking actin and the goddamn sliding myofilaments, okay, I get ya, shit. A super family of molecular motors. Smooth muscles, your stomach, your airways, your blood vessels, let's see, they use sodium and calcium and potassium. Apparently your muscles to, you know, produce whatever to move, there's potassium and sodium, which somehow the potassium and the sodium, the walls weaken and then they can pass through and then there's electricity and then that produces calcium as a waste and then it gets rid of the calcium somehow. The human body, fucking human body, huh? So, let's see, potassium and sodium, K+, Na+, calcium, 640 muscles. Yeah, I guess that's about it, right? So there's a quote that was on my high school basketball team, the wall in the locker room, and it said to learn as if you're going to live forever and live as if you're going to die tomorrow. So I feel like that's kind of, I've been hearing that quote over and over again. So let's go over these muscles, right? It's good to know the muscles. It's good to know the purposes and the functions of the muscles, right? We use muscles to generate heat. We use muscles to stabilize our joints. We use muscles for our posture. We also use muscles for our movement. And some of the muscle names: gastrocnemius, soleus, biceps femoris, which I think is in your legs, this biceps femoris, flexor carpi radialis, Paul Morris Longus Extensor Carpi Ulnaris Extensor Carpi Radialis Vastus Lateris Semimembranous Semitendinosus Thoracolumbar Fascia Orbicularis Oris Extensor Digitorum Gracilis Vastus Lateris Rectus Femoris Triceps Brachii Latissimus Dorsi Gluteus Medius Gluteus Minimus Gluteus Maximus Soleus Biceps Brachii Pectoralis Major Deltoid Teres Major Trapezius and the rhomboid. To the rhomboid.